Hello, today we are going to review this output bounding circuit. Without further ado, let's focus on the first stage op-amp and D1 and begin with assuming the input voltage to this op-amp is positive. This will lead the output VO1 to swing to the negative saturation threshold, which is minus 12 volts. The reason for this is because the op-amp non-inverting terminal V+ is grounded. So the potential difference between V- and V+ terminal is negative. At the same time, D1, which is a Zener diode, will be forward biased and act as a normal diode, since its cathode terminal now has a negative potential and its anode terminal is virtually grounded through the V- terminal. So this will cause D1 to conduct and limit the output voltage VO1 to minus 0.7 volts. Remember, since the anode has a 0 volt and it is forward conducting, then its cathode must have a 0.7 volt less than anode. So we will get now let's assume the input has a negative potential. In this case, since the V- now is smaller than V+ terminal, then the output VO1 will swing to its positive saturation limit, which is positive 12 volt. This will put the Zener diode D1 in a reverse bias, and since the op-amp output saturation limit is positive 12 volt, then the Zener diode will be at its breakdown region and will limit the output to the positive 6 volt. Therefore, we will get again, remember, this is because D1 anode terminal is virtually grounded. Here is the first stage output VO1 waveform in respect to the input signal. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. This will really help the channel to grow and obviously encourage me to continue creating more and better content. Back to the video, and now we are going to determine the output of the second stage op-amp in respect to its input signal, which is VO1. Here is the negative 0.7 volt is applied to the non-inverting terminal V-. This will lead the output of the op-amp to swing to its positive saturation point, which is 12 volt. Therefore, D2 will be forward biased and act as a normal diode. In this case, the output will be limited at a positive 0.7 volt because the cathode of D2 is virtually grounded. Here is what we get at the output. Now let's continue with the next cycle when the input signal to the second op-amp becomes positive 6 volt. This will push the op-amp output to swing to its negative saturation point, which is minus 12 volt. This change will put the diode D2 at the reverse bias because its cathode is virtually grounded. Therefore, this Zener diode will be at its breakdown region and will start conducting and limiting the output voltage at minus 9 volt, which it is rated for. So we will get remember that D1 and D2 have a different Zener voltage rates. D1 is rated for 6 volts and D2 is rated for 9 volts. Here is the final output waveform. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you are still struggling the concept of op-amp swings and Zener diode biasing regions, I have another video which provides some details on these topics with an example. You can find the video link under the description. Please like, subscribe, and push the notification bell if you would like to get notified when I publish new videos.